Hi everyone, this is Paul Lang from DTS with the DTS Play of the Week. For the week ending 10-1, this play was Adobe, and this was a swing trade. This was by far and away my best trade this week, to say the least. It was a little bit of a struggling week for me. It was based on the daily chart, of course, to some extent, but it came down to the hourly DTS buy setup, the form entry down to the 5-minute chart. We'll take a look at the chart in just a minute. Management, advanced, and the reward to risk. Again, I want to run through the numbers with you. It depends how you interpret this. This swing move was a 6.8-to-1 move. I took part of the trade at the end of the day and held a half risk, half the trade as the swing trade. So the profit was actually half of the total profit you would figure for a 6.8 because I held half for the last 2 days. So you can figure the numbers as you see them here. I just want to be clear exactly what that meant. The move in the chart was 6.8, but I held a half position for the bulk of the move. Adobe, 927, 60-minute chart you're looking at, and the daily chart you're looking at. This daily chart down here, that little inset right there, that's the day, Wednesday, when it had a neutral day after that drop to support. Had a little sideways day. I was looking to play that. I was very bullish on the market and wanted to play out a swing trade. I chose Adobe. This hourly buy setup happened right in there. But to find the actual entry, I came down to a 5-minute chart that morning. I got in a little bit early, giving it a little bit of room. I wasn't sure if it was going to take off early or not, so I came in on a 15-minute chart that you're looking at here. Took the entry there. It was given room on the entry. The entry was actually 146 over 146.30, stop under 145.90. And as the trade progressed, I adjusted the stop down 10 cents well before it came down there. It was necessary and actually saved this trade. It's something I teach a lot is about management of entries and stops. It's not done all the time, it's done certain situations, and that particular strategy, that concept, actually makes over 3 times the money that it loses for me. So something that I teach and really adhere to very strongly. The profit was taken somewhat at the end of that first day. My simple plan is to get in a swing trade early during the day with full size as a day trade, and then to reduce it to a swing portion at the end of the day. So I unloaded half to reduce it down to a swing portion, and then the swing portion was held. So the profit from the actual full day trade was minimal, but it allowed me to hold a half swing trade. The next morning, stop was adjusted down to allow for that dip. Remember, it was a half portion at that point. And then from there, the stock flew over the next 2 days. It actually is still open. I did not close this out. I was going to. I decided not to at the last minute, but it doesn't matter. It had a nice close. It may go a little higher. It may close it out if it gaps up on Monday. But that's where it is as a Friday, and it'll probably be closed out sometime on Friday. So overall, very nice move for a 3-day swing. Again, that swing portion was actually at half shares. The full shares is only on Wednesday. So that's why the risk reward is greater than what the actual profit is, because it was a half position held. The DTS Trading Room, the place for you to be. Read the screen here, take a look if it's for you. If you are around trading during the day, I highly encourage you to at least get in there and take a trial and see what it's all about. For DTS, this is Paul Lang. Until next time, good trading, everybody.